Hello everyone, my name is Manasvi and I'm part of the Azure Identity team at Microsoft. In this video, we will discuss Azure AD application permissions in detail and provide a demonstration of how to configure them using the Azure portal. We will also demonstrate how to use application permissions to execute a Graph API. Let's quickly revise the two methods Azure AD applications can use to access protected resources. The first method is through delegated access, where the application acts on behalf of a signed-in user. The second method is through app-only access, where the application acts only as its own identity. In the delegated access scenario, the application uses delegated permissions, and in the app-only scenario, the application uses application permissions. We will delve deeper into the concept of application permissions in this video. Application permissions are used in scenarios such as automation and backup, where the application would run as a background service or daemon without any user interaction. Only administrators can grant application permissions. Applications are statically consented with the pre-configured permissions on the app registration. With application permissions, client credential grant flow with .defaultScope is used to acquire tokens to access resources. Since it is required to use the application credentials, which can be a certificate or a secret, use of application permissions is recommended in a confidential client scenario only. In this demo, we will explore how to set up application permissions using the Azure portal and use those permissions to call a Graph API. For this, let's first go to the Azure AD portal and open App Registrations Blade. Click on New Registration and provide a name in the name field. For this demo, we will use the name App Permission Demo and leave all other settings at their default. Click the Register button to complete the app registration process. Take note of the tenant ID and application ID shown on the overview plate, as these will be used in the client credential flow later to generate access token for Graph. Click on API permissions, and since this application will be used for app-only scenario, remove the default delegated permission user.read. Then, click on Add a permission, and then go and select Microsoft Graph API. Under this, select Application Permissions. For this demo, we will use the application permission user.read.all to list the basic details of all the users in the tenant. Select this and click Add Permissions at the bottom. Admin consent is needed in advance for application permissions. So click Grant Admin Consent for your tenant option. Next, open the Certificates and Secrets blade to generate a secret for acquiring tokens using client credential grant with application permissions. Click on New Secret and provide an appropriate description. For this demo, we will use Demo Secret as the description and the default stays 180 days. Make sure to note down the secret value as it will not be visible once moved away from the blade. Next, we will use the client ID and secret to generate an access token using Postman. Postman is a platform that provides an API repository, tools, workspaces, and integrations to simplify every step of the API lifecycle. It helps to design, test, and document APIs quickly. We will use Postman and the client credential flow to first generate an app-only token. This will be used to make the Graph API call that lists users in a tenant. Here is an example of a client credential grant request. Replace the tenant ID, client ID, and client secret with the values noted earlier from the app registration and click Get New Access Token option. Once we get the access token, we can use that to invoke Graph API. But before that, let us examine the token and see how it looks using a tool like jwt.ms. As you can see, the roles claim contains the application permission that we configured earlier. Now, we will invoke the Graph API for listing users using this token. Click on Send, and you should see a 200 OK result with the list of users in the response. This concludes the demo of using application permissions to invoke a Graph API. In summary, application permissions enable an application to access a resource using its own identity. These permissions are granted in advance by an administrator and consented to before the app runs. Applications should use client credential flow to acquire tokens with the .default scope in order to access resources. This video should have provided a helpful understanding of what application permissions are and how to use them. Thank you for watching.